Hi everybody, it's Lisa, owner of Peaches Skincare. You can visit us at peachesskincare.com, and I also encourage you to follow us on Instagram and Facebook, where you can see a little bit more about who we are and our holistic beliefs in skincare. Today I'm going to talk about your skin in the winter, or when it's a different environment. Many people are telling you to change your skincare, or it's time to change your regime, and that's just simply not true. We take care of our bodies all year long by eating healthy foods, by drinking plenty of water, and you don't change that just because it becomes colder outside or hotter outside. So what happens is we all kind of go inside in the winter. We maybe don't eat as well, we maybe are not hydrating our bodies as well, we're eating more chocolate chip cookies in front of the fireplace and hot chocolate, and we're maybe even drinking more alcohol. We're also turning on our heaters more and our fireplaces, and that affects your hair, and it affects your skin, and it affects your body in many ways. Many people actually gain weight during this time. Changing your skincare regime is not something you should be doing. You want to stick to feeding your skin and caring for your skin as you always have. But you can take care of it or hydrate it more by drinking more water. I probably drink 6 to 8 of these a day. I'm constantly hydrating, whether it's winter, spring, or summer. And yes, I live in Southern California, but I did live in Ohio for a while and Oregon, and I never changed my regime. I just made sure to hydrate more. When you feel itchy, when your eyes feel dry, hydrate your body. It's many times your body telling you you need more water. As far as your hair goes, do more leave-in conditioners, more conditioning masks. You can use olive oil on your hair. Just make sure at night that you're protecting your skin and you're pulling your hair back. And as you know, I like you to change your pillowcase every day. As far as your skin goes, here are a couple of the things that I do. I love to take Vaseline brand Vaseline. I don't really recommend any other brands. I just like Vaseline. And if you're feeling dehydrated, you can do your regime or on clean skin, or even overnight, just take some Vaseline. You can do this to your hands. You can do this to your feet. Sometimes I'll put a little sock over my hands, or I do put little socks on my feet every night with moisturizer. But you can take the Vaseline and pretend like you just have chapped lips. Just put it all over your face. Now, many times I'll walk around with this on while I do chores around the house or any paperwork, make sure I don't have any clumps anywhere. And just let it soak in. Now, Vaseline doesn't penetrate the barriers of the skin, the epidermis, dermis, stratum, corneum, but it does lock in moisture, and it does hydrate the skin. So that's one trick with Vaseline. A second trick can be using extra virgin olive oil. And you know I love extra virgin olive oil, and the same trick would hold true. You can put extra virgin olive oil on your nails. You can put extra virgin olive oil all over your body. It's very hydrating. In fact, we use it in the salons to get all the blood flowing and massage the face and the body before we start doing the facial. And you can use it on your skin. Extra virgin olive oil has squalene in it. It is a pure antioxidant. It is incredibly healing to the skin. The skin can drink it in, and it is a beautiful way to hydrate. Don't be afraid that you will break out. It's absolutely rare that you would break out unless you have some type of, I suppose, an allergy to olives or olive oil, or you put foundation on your face right after when your skin is trying to eat it in or drink it in and feed itself. Another thing I really love is castor oil. Now, castor oil does not have a lot of studies on it, but I can tell you it has been used for years. Many grandparents had their children or our parents drink it, and I don't even remember what that was for. But castor oil has helped me to grow my eyelashes, has helped me to grow my eyebrows, and I started actually testing it, and I'm going to do a before and after at the end of this video. I have the deepest lines that I would have would be my expressive lines right here, and they're really not bad, but I tried to ignore them for a couple days and let my skin get maybe a little dehydrated up there just to show you a good wrinkle. But I have been putting castor oil right on them overnight. Yes, I still love to wear my milk and magnesia, and many times I will put it over it. And I am amazed at how much castor oil has softened those lines and hydrated my skin. You can put castor oil all over your skin if you would like. Let it hydrate your skin. Let it really keep that moisture in your skin. Castor oil is also an antioxidant as well, and it has healing properties. It heals scars, and I have actually seen that for myself. It can take away dark spots on the skin, and I have seen that. And many holistic practitioners recommend it around the eyes for irritated eyes or swollen eyes. I, in fact, started putting it on my eyelids because I was told that I had eczema, and I knew that that wasn't true. And what I found is that when I put it on at night over my eyelids, when I woke up in the morning, my eyes didn't feel dry or irritated. So castor oil is another way to keep your skin hydrated. I also don't believe that you need a moisturizer for morning and night. One moisturizer is great. You don't need to change it up throughout the year. A moisturizer, I'll use my example of Classic Moisturizer by Peaches, should be filled with antioxidants. It should be filled with healing properties like go-to cola. It should do things to your skin like hyaluronic acid that keeps your skin hydrated, locks moisture in your skin, and is feeding your skin. You know I believe that skincare should be like face food or pure antioxidants. And I base that on a Harvard University study that was done many years ago that showed that antioxidants penetrate the skin and actually cause change. So you do not need a moisturizer for morning and then night, and you don't need to change your moisturizer for a different part of the year. I'm also an advocate of eye cream. I know many people tell you it is a marketing ploy and people are just trying to get money out of you for eye cream, and that may be the case in some instances. But a good eye cream should have vitamin Ks, vitamin Es, things that help with swelling of the eye area or darkening of the eye area. So use an eye cream. Be regimented with an eye cream. And I think the most important thing I can say is be on a regime. Be regimented. Don't go to bed with bad things on your skin, because that can absolutely change your skin in 5 to 8 to 10 hours in a very negative way. Be diligent with your skin, take care of your skin, feed your skin, and just keep it hydrated during these winter months. I hope this helped you. Many of these things can be used all over your body. Make sure you're drinking a lot of water. And these were just some at-home things. If you have wonderful moisturizers you love to use or hydrating masks you love to use, now's the time to up your game on it. And find an esthetician. Find a master esthetician that can take care of your skin, and the winter months are such a great time to really be on your game. Get in more. I do facials at least once a week, if not every 2 weeks, and when I go in to train with my girls, which is quite often, I actually have microdermabrasion and microcurrent done to my face probably 5 and 10 times in one day, and I love it, and the results are amazing. So stick to a regime. I hope this helped you with the winter months, and I hope you all stay beautiful naturally.